Alright guys, welcome back to Wind Chaser. Just rented a DN spreader. Have some rain coming in. What our plan of attack is to do is we just finished up all of our primary tillage of our newly acquired fields. A lot of them had some kind of a chop straw residue, so we were able to capitalize on that. And then we also sprayed it with NPK. So we pretty much did primary tillage with our 2720s on all of those fields, and just to boost. Just to boost our starting nutrients to get it back up to hopefully respectable levels. Broadcasting some lime over these fields. Jake did a really bad job. He said this was 6.2, 6.4. I don't know what he's talking quick work for broadcasting nutrients. Be a little bit high, a little bit basic in these fields, but what can you do? We only farm these fields for one season. The other ones were farmed too. this thing is rated at 24 miles an hour, it's like you can sufficiently broadcast at that operating speed based on John Deere's specs. Plus, it's just limestone, so it really cares. It's not a very windy day here. He's running the Tiger Mate 200. Fucked up. So he's over here spraying and cultivating. This field over here. So those were 6.4. Those will probably be... this season, just because our soil is going to be really good, our moisture is going to be really good. See, now this field is 57. 5% moisture. That's the difference between farming and not farming. Because if you're just relying on rains, it's not going to really, the soil moisture won't really be maintained. It will slowly whittle away to nothing unless you're actively farming it and spraying it and maintaining the nutrient. It's not gonna correct itself out with rains. Rain helps to maintain, but you really need to be actively spraying to increase your soil moisture. Because if you just leave it alone and expect rain to correct for all the warm days, it's really not gonna happen. These are pretty small fields over here. Some of the smallest, except for a couple over there by the dairy. They might be small, but man, you sure can pull a lot of corn out of these fields here. Especially field 10. I mean, it doesn't look like much, but we pulled like four or five trucks of corn out of here, so. It definitely is these fields over here are definitely money makers. 11 really hasn't been too good to us for soybeans. It's either we're low on nutrients or we're plagued by low moisture, or it seems like these last two seasons it's been one or the other, so hopefully we can dial it in this third season and really make these fields produce. I think we're going to plant some corn and something over there in 11. Give soybeans a break. Plant some corn and till in that corn residue, and hopefully that helps us out. Because the soybean residue is essentially just chopped straw. That doesn't really give us the PK that we really need. Fifteen is another pretty big field. Doesn't look like much, but when you're over there farming at it, it's a lot of ground to cover. 12 is tiny. It's always tiny. It looks tiny. It feels tiny when you're farming it. So I mean, it's just a small field, but it's still. We still pull a lot of grain out of there if we were to plant it with corn, which I think we will. I think we're going to give 15 a break with corn. Just try to switch it up a little bit. I think we're going to be planting beans over here. We're running continuous corn over in this field for some time. You got to already see what our nutrients are in this field. Pretty high nutrients, so it's going to be a good year to take corn off and put beans or something on here. Same with 15. If we run 15, 10, 6 and 7 can probably still be corn. Could run 11, 12 is corn. and then we can run some of our more open, bigger fields as like barley and maybe canola. Probably run big field like 17. You know, the boys will want to do a big cornfield, so we could probably do 17 as corn. That could be our big cornfield. And we could plant, you know, like barley and soybeans, like 3 soybeans, 2 barley, 1 canola, and then maybe like another smaller field of corn or beans. We'll figure it out. We have a great demand coming up on day 41. It's day 38. So in 3 days, we're going to be unloading a lot of grain for soybean, I think. Or corn, I'm not really sure. That's all she wrote for this field. So this field nutrients are a little bit lower than field 10, as you can see. We should run this again as corn. Definitely needs a good dose of limestone, so that's what we're doing here. Alfalfa is already regrowing, so. Just cruising over these fields, broadcasting our line as quick as possible. actually really enjoy this field. This field is fun to, I mean, it has really good scenery surrounding it. It's pretty much in the middle of the map. Or, you know, the middle section of the map, so everywhere you look, there's, you know, detail all over. You know, it has the kind of subtle hills, and, you know, it's not totally flat, and, I don't know, it's fun to the farm, but it, I think it's going to look really cool when we start doing beans on this field. 20 is just the big field of alfalfa. Spring when your pH is down to 6.2 off after the second harvest. And a lot of farm management, a lot of money is going into our ground here. Spent a lot of money on nutrients, a lot of money on herbicides. But our nutrients is pretty good right now. This is what we ended up. That's what our harvest value was, 57% moisture, 8-4. So if we just increase that that moisture a little bit, we have a little rain in the forecast. My little indicator here. So hopefully by the time we get this all cultivated in, we can go ahead and plant, and hopefully some great demands come around. We can sell our grain, and, you know, we got a lot of the boring work done. All of our primary tillage, you know, we just had to just get it done. You know, a pair of 2720s in the fields, and we did work. We did 17, 18, 3, 1, 2, 13, 14, 26, 25, you know, so about 60-65%, if not 70% of our land, we had to pretty much chisel plow. And fortunately, our nutrients are pretty good in these fields we are farming, so we don't really have to chisel plow in this residue or our nutrients or this lime, because we're not trying to play catch up, where like our fields we just acquired, the nutrients were 0-0 with like 14% moisture, so they required a significant amount of work. And the best way to like jump that up quickly is by plowing it in, because you always get the biggest benefit when you plow it in. So we chisel plowed in all that residue, we chisel plowed in that grass, we chisel plowed in the NPK we sprayed. So when the soil mod kind of updates itself, we should be looking at some pretty respectable levels of nutrients in those fields. Now, the lease on those fields is only 20 days, so basically when it comes towards harvesting time, we will no longer have a lease on them, we will no longer own them, so all we'll be able to do is just kind of harvest, get our harvest done, and then hopefully pay off some loans, maybe release those fields for field work purposes, and hopefully everything works out. Now, we won't be able to spray anything until we release, so, but We'll worry about that when it comes. We definitely want to keep leasing the fields we've already put such an investment in, like all of the nutrients, the time. You know, it's, it takes probably 3 hours to plow a medium-sized field, if not more, so... Plus the time it takes to spray, the money it takes to actually buy all the nutrients. So, I mean, there's quite an investment in these fields, and... Well, what the hell is going on? So we're obviously going to want to keep farming the fields that we already acquired, and, you know, maybe pick up one or two more as we go. But it's definitely not cheap. I think the taxes, like we got burnt up, like $30,000 it cost us, like, between stuff that we sold and our land that we're leasing. So it's not cheap to farm the land that we have. Because we're also taxed on land value, we're taxed on income, and plus we have the $10,000 or whatever it was, $14,000 a day that it costs us to lease. How about that? We're down 3% and we just finished, so... I'm gonna see if I can fill up over here at this depot. Or if I have to go back to CPS and refill. So about 40 minutes in. Fields that we just purchased, they obviously don't need limestone, so we need to do 20, 27, 20, 44, 11, and 12, 24 perhaps. So we did 6, 7, 10, 15, then we have 11 and 12, and then we can move over to closer to the farm. So Jacoboo, Tiger Mate 200, pretty fancy schmancy rig over there. So just look at the kind of pH we got, 9, slightly basic. So you can see our NPK and limestone. Slightly basic, so once we hit it with like herbicide and stuff, it'll go back down, but 10, 5, think the soil stuff updates with the crops, but apparently it says we have 1 day left of wheat production, so that's good. I think he's doing 2 headland passes and then he'll go back to... I was contemplating of buying field 4 and 5 down here. You know, having some small cornfields or something. Some of these grassy patches that, you know, they're really convenient when you're farming dairy down here, but we're not really doing dairy in this. On this server yet, so anyways, this will be really nice. We fill up at CPS, then we knock out 11 and 12, and now we can buzz on over to like 20, 27, 28, 44. 28, 27, that will quit. And I think I have triggers over there like a refill with wine. Oops. Thinking of making a 5-section disc, was it a 26, 23, 25 disc, something like that? One of those big John Deere 5-folds to go with the 2720, since I pretty much already built the frame, I just build, you know, slap some more wings on it, bigger wings, extend the discs out, and, you know, make a few little changes in the model that some updates and have me a big disc for cultivating. This definitely wouldn't be a plow, it would be a disc or a cultivator. Jake is just itching to start farming these fields over here, like 33. He's in love with 33. He likes all the big stuff. Me, I like the idea of starting small and growing big, and, you know, I always play on level hard, and I took out monster loans to buy some equipment, you know, so we're basically, our net worth is like negative $1.5 million right now. I really like the idea that we can lease land, however, like, every time you unlease it or sell it, it, like, messes up the terrain, so hopefully they'll fix that. Sometime in the near future.
So the boys said that we got 76 bales out of field 20. So hopefully we can get, you know, close to 100 bales, because that would be really great. Because that would be roughly anywhere, but that'd probably be close to like 120, 130,000 of profit off of that field. So, you know, and it doesn't cost us anything. We don't really plow it. We don't plant it. We just let it grow again, and it grows and grows and grows every season now. So all we do is just keep mowing it, bale it, merge it, bale it, sell it, mow it, merge it, bale it, sell it. Very low cost of ownership, low cost of farm. And this is another field that really needs lime. Okay, so I'll probably end the video here and just try to do more of this off camera, so thanks for watching.